Hello everyone and welcome back to Metroid Prime Blind. And in this episode, I'm going to be going in through here because last time I saw that this was the impact crater and I had a tough ass fight with Bloomin' Meta Ridley and even Meta. I don't know how to pronounce it and stuff because I'm terrible at pronunciations, but you should know that already. And yeah, let's just get into it and see if this is the end of the game, because I get the feeling it is. I mean, it's got like kind of presentation to it, hasn't it? It's pretty similar. Impact crater. Alright, even though we've already seen this at the end of the last one, but never mind. Well then, so, what am I going to do? I have all 100% items and stuff, making things a little bit easier for me. And there's a save room, right about, where's the save room? What? Wait, there's a save room? Where's the save room? Oh, this is the save room! How the heck did I not even notice that? Do I want to save? Yeah, I don't see why not. So there was literally no point last time in doing any of that, in going back to the ship and restoring, but I'm not to know and stuff, because this is blind, you know? I've never played this game before, what can I say? Anyway, well, what's through here then? Oh, it's not the final boss, it's a completely different area that I have to traverse my way through. Is there anything, though, that I can scan? Hang on, what is this? Limited data on unknown material available. Material is highly radioactive. You will take damage from direct contact. Multigenic qualities at least 86% greater than Phazon. Oh god. Unshielded bioforms below index level P will suffer fatality within moments. Well goddammit, I need to be a little bit careful in that and all the going through here and stuff, don't I, right? So then basically the whole idea is don't touch the floor. The floor is lava, basically, is what it's saying. Alright. So I kinda wanna get rid of all these to make things a lot easier for me going by. Except those things are immune to it by the looks of it, are they? No, they die. That's a bit morbid and a half, isn't it? And they just continuously keep going. Is there anything I can platform on? No, there isn't. Then again, what is this blue thing exactly? The blue thing doesn't really look like it's anything. So you know what, let's just try and jump through like this. There we go, that was a bit better, wasn't it? Cool, so don't touch the floor. It's good though, because I don't have to listen for any humming noises or look around, because you know, it's all just where it is. Oh my god, yeah, this has definitely got a very strong feel to... Oh my god, it's these goddamn things! No! Oh jeez, great, blooming Metroids in an area like this. Yeah, it is definitely a lot like a Taurian in this case. Alright, I need to switch to this one and then get you down like this. There we go, right, yeah, because I fought these guys before to make it a lot easier for me. Alright. You know, in like the other areas and stuff like that, but still, because I noticed they have elements, meaning their elements are weakness to my certain beam powers. But yeah, in Super Metroid, there was a Taurian place, you know, which was basically the final level and stuff before you find Mother Brain and things. And yeah, it gives me very, very strong vibes of that, I will say. Can I get you down before you even attack me? Oh my god, you actually just morphed into a completely different thing, didn't you? And I'm gonna try and dodge? That didn't really work though. Never mind. At least now I know to use my power beam and that in order to make things a lot easier for me. If I don't kill these guys fast enough though, I think they probably like morph into other Metroids to make things a little bit more stressful for me. But you know what, never mind. Let's go see that how we do. I'm honestly surprised I didn't die on that Meta Ridley, because that would be blooming annoying as hell. Alright. Oh my god, it's not one of these things. Wait, is that a normal one? No, it isn't. It's one that requires ice, right? Can I get you before you can get me? Haha, I can. So now you're going to change into this one. But I already know which one you are anyway. So you're just going to do that. And this thing right here has ignored me. Okay, right, cool. I'm getting the hang of this. These guys aren't really that bad. To start with, they're goddamn annoying as hell. I also like how when I defeat them, they don't really give me any items or anything. That adds to the tension, doesn't it? Oh my god, these are bones! I'm on like top of bones and stuff, I think, anyway. Is this what they look like? This is definitely a creepy place and stuff. And this is what it's like, in the center of everything. Oh my god, it's you. Okay, I wanna try and take him out from below before, like, venturing anywhere else. You are right here! There you are! Right, okay. I wanna lock onto this one, and then just take him out nice and easily if possible, if that thing would move out the way. God damn it. Never mind. This is where the commentary is going to be really weird and stuff, but come on, guys. We're in like, the final area of the game. How the hell am I supposed to react to a place like this, you know? I suppose I could use super missiles, but I really want to save those for the actual final boss that I get to be honest. All I know is that even the music has a very strong last area feel for Super Metroid and things. and I freaking love it. Okay, are there any other Metroids now I'm gonna have to fight in this area? I get your feeling that there is. Unless maybe at the top is where the actual final boss is. It might actually not be as long as a journey as, you know, I thought in that. I'm honestly surprised there's, like, no point of return in that, because some games have that, you know, where you'll save... Oh, freaking hell, I called it. There'll be, like, a point in that, you know, where you'll save and on, like, the game and stuff. And, you know, you won't be able to return to get any of the last remaining items because it's too late by then, isn't it? Alright, cool, anyway, let's just get him down and over with. Can I just... Actually, one thing I'm forgetting is that I can use my, power bombs in order to get those guys done over with and stuff. But again, I want to save it for the final boss. The final boss might actually be really hard and require pretty much all that you've got. Okay, right, so let's see. There's a red door. Oh my god, there's two of them. There's two red doors, is there? Maybe that one up there is... This could be a save room, right? Aha! It's a save room! So I can just continuously restore my health along the way. Oh wait, no, it's the map. Or missile? Is the missile recharge room? Yeah, it's the missile recharge room because it's got that kind of camera angle, isn't it? Alright, nice. Thank you. Thank you very much for the missiles and stuff, even though I haven't really used any at the minute, but cheers! Alright. And if I go out, are they gonna reset? Any of the Metroids reset? Can I snipe? Or at least can I get them stealthily? That's the question. Because I'd like to try and get this one over here before he morphs into the thing. That didn't appear. Oh my god, I gotta switch to the other one. Can I get you down like this, please? No, I can't. Oh my god. Alright, you know what? Fine. One power bomb. I don't even blimmin' care anymore. God damn it. Because I have to keep switching my beams and stuff, and it's not really helping me out, is it? Can I get you like that? Oh my god, and he actually morphed into the one that I needed. Awesome. Alright, so if you could kindly... Oh my god. Yeah, what I want to do is move out the way like that. There we go. Because they go in a straight line. Where the hell did he come from, man? I thought I blew him up. What the hell is this madness? Alright, ice beam? Ice beam, maybe? Is that right? Yeah, it's an ice beam, and now he's morphing into the... You know what? Power bomb. Just get rid of him, please. Jesus. Right, okay. Is that all of them? No, there's one more. Right. I want to get you down nice and quick, and then dodge. The dodging didn't really work, though, did it? Well, god damn it. Alright, go to this one. Turn around. And just kill it before it morphs or something, please. Right, there we go. Unless maybe I'm supposed to avoid them and just continue on, but I don't know. Why are there fish? There's fish in the impact crater. Everything else looks hellish and evil, and we just got fish over there. That is rather strange. Oh my god, there's more of them. Alright, can I get you before you at least see me? No, I can't. Of course I can't. Oh no! I want to try and move out the way. Oh no. Oh god. Oh jeez. Okay. Get off of me, please. Alright. Are you going to do your thing? Yeah, you're going to morph into one of these. Can you just die, please? Oh my god, and there's three of you this time. This is not going good, man. This is not going good at all. Oh, jeez. I swear I, like, jumped out of the way then. Oh my god. For the last area in the game and that, I am doing absolutely horrible. Alright, let's just try and get you down like that. There we go. And, oh my god, wow, I'm actually getting energy back this time. That's kind of weird. Alright, okay. Do they just keep regenerating or something, though? Because they always seem to keep coming towards me. There's one over there. Do they just keep coming? Can I just literally just get to the top then without these guys killing me? That would be a lot better, I think. Because there's another red door over here, isn't there? And this one actually leads to the place, I think? Let me just check on the map. Yeah. It seems to. Wait, just ignore that one then, because those guys are taking forever to beat. Okay. Right. Oh, I know what I gotta do. I got a spider ball. I gotta spider ball my way through like this, right? And, oh, right, I need to use my bomb jumping all the way up there and stuff. Oh, this is neat. This is a really, really cool way to get by, isn't it? Because hopefully now I'm not going to touch anything, because I get the feeling that if I do, I'm dead. And I don't really want to be dead at a time like this. There's a spider ball, though, that goes down here. It's probably not worth it, though, because that stuff looks pretty dangerous. So, you know what, let's just go in and... Oh my god. What the hell is this thing? This must be the final boss, right? I guess that's my theory, anyway. This is just like Bloomin' Jack 2 Renegade with the final boss. It's got that same sort of feel. And I approve. Even though it probably didn't take inspiration from Jack 2 at all. Oh my Jesus. This thing looks ginormous and very threatening. Oh my god, what? Holy crap. I don't even know what to call this thing. It's some kind of spider, alien thingy. It's unknown to me what the hell I should call this thing even, but never mind. Alright, but can I at least scan you and know what the hell to do? Wherever you are. Do I need to use my x-ray or something? No, I don't. I just gotta wait. Is that right? Unless I have to go down. What? Whoa, what? Whoa, what is going on? What? Oh my god, what? Oh my god, it's this thing. Okay, right. No, Metroid Prime? Oh my god, this thing's called Metroid Prime. That's why it's called Metroid Prime. That's cool, man. Alright, Metroid Prime. Wow, highly evolved. Phase on producing life form. The aberration, known as Metroid Prime, is the source of Phazon, making it immensely powerful. A genetic flaw makes it susceptible to certain weapons for brief periods. Only its head is truly vulnerable. Right, got it. Other attacks are a nuisance. Offensively, Metroid Prime has a number of natural and mechanical weapons at its disposal. These include, Ultra Frigid Breath. Multi-missiles, snare beams, and particle wave projectors. I'm screwed. Its massive strength and barbed carapace, or whatever, make it lethal in melee combat. Recommend maximum firepower when engaging this enemy. Right, so his weak point is his head, basically. So I gotta shoot his head in order to do the thing. But I get the feeling that he can't actually be damaged with this. He can more be damaged with my natural enemies. Enemies? No, energies. That's what I'm trying to say, man. Alright, so yeah, because that damages you like this, doesn't it? So I need to hit you or so right in the eyes in order to get you down, right? So maybe the Phazon does work after all. Let me just try out a whole bunch of stuff on this guy then. Just to be double certain. Right, let's try and hit you in the eyes. And that doesn't do anything, yeah. So if the Phazon doesn't work, or at least, you know, the plasma beam doesn't work, then I just need to use this instead in order to get you down. Right? I think that's my theory anyway. Question is, can I get a super missile on you? Oh my god, yeah, I can! And that's your weak point too, huh? That's cool, man. And oh god, he jumps towards me as well. Right, he's purple this time too. Right, oh no, I getcha. I know exactly what I gotta do then. He's changing into this, so therefore I need to use this thing in order to get him down. And I can use this to drain you like this. Right? I understand, and I got this. Cool. This is such a cool way for a final boss, combining all of your powers and things. I love it. What can I say? Alright, now you're going to be ice? No, you're still plasma, huh? You're still plasma, same as before. Right, let's just do the same thing then that I did before. Drain you like this. Because that should hopefully get you down or so, yeah. And I have like 181 missiles remaining, so I really need to be a little bit careful of what I'm doing. You still require this one though, right? I see. Oh wait, no, now you switch to ice. I think that's ice, isn't it? Is it ice? Yeah, it's ice, that's for sure. Cool, so then I can use this thing right here, right? Yeah! Now we're getting somewhere, and that will get you down like this. Okay, is there at least a point though, where I can get, all of my things back? You know, all of my missiles and stuff, because I have like 171 left at the minute. Let's just go for it again. Oh man, I missed it that time. And that's because I need to switch to this instead, right? Alright, go for a super missile. And completely missed. That didn't go well at all, man. What, do I have to shoot in the mouth? No, wait, I have to shoot in the eyes, I remember. Yeah, so let's just get you down like that. I'm getting a feeling every time I use at least one press of that, I need to keep note of what I'm doing. Because the other ones, you know, I press it and it just continuously does it. With the wave beam. And a plasma beam, because of, like, you know, they set out, like, this shock or so, which gets him down. Alright, so now, what's he doing? He's, oh my god, what? Okay, that was the most strangest thing of all time. Alright, see now if I can just get you down like this. Cool. I like this, though. This is a really, really clever way, you know, for the final boss and stuff. Again, though, what the hell is this thing? Part of me thinks it's a spider. It's like some kind of giant deformed spider and that's trying to kill me. And now he's gonna go this way. Do I need to morph ball underneath him in order to dodge that? I think I probably do. And he You know what? Oh god, he's switching to this again. Alright, let's do at least one thing, maybe. Like one super missile. Like so. Because then it causes this explosion and that in order to get you down, doesn't it? Alright, jump. No, jumping doesn't appear to work, the dodging, but whatever. I've still got one goddamn energy tag. Why am I doing better on this guy when compared to Ridley? That makes no sense. But you know what? I will take it, so whatever. Alright, cool. Let's just freeze you and then get you down like that. And I actually still have a lot of missiles left. This is why I am glad that I chose, you know, to get all 100% items, because then this guy is not really that much of a problem anymore. Ah, now we're on to the plasma, are we? Okay, I love me some plasma, man. You know, I don't mind it. Like, I'm just talking to the boss like it's my friend or something. Because you know what, you can just get down easily, can't you? I think, anyway, yeah. I didn't really want to use a missile, you know, at least one of my super missile beam combination thingamajigs on that, because flamethrower, last time I used it, and that drains it an awful goddamn lot. But I might just save it for the ones where they just, for the ice and, you know, the natural power beam, because then it just suits it normally, doesn't it? Alright. Because this one, again, you know, that will, like, shoot this massive beam or so, which doesn't really appear to work, stuff like that, but still. I'm glad, though, that when you shoot stuff, they do kind of home in on him as well. Meaning that, you know, when I shoot one of these charge things, he just continuously goes down. Alright, let's try Morph Ball next time. Morph Balling, yeah, doesn't really work. And now he's switching to... Oh, it's still the wave thing, isn't it? Yeah, I see. Cool. That's fine by me, man. You continue doing your thing, and I'll sit you down. And after all this, I've lost one energy tank. Oh, boy. I get the feeling, though, that when I'm finding him normally, I need to be a little bit more careful with what I'm doing. Alright, now let's go again. There we go. And wow, he's actually nearly down already. Oh, wow, and now I found out how to dodge it. So I just gotta jump a little bit out of the way, right? Okay, now ice. God damn it, man, this is actually pretty cool. Alright, switch to the... I'm gonna charge and use this. There we go. Then now, massive explosion. And Metroid Prime, you were nearly down. Oh, wow, it actually brings me back my missiles as well. Oh dear. I didn't notice that. Okay, and... Oh, really? I thought the last one would at least be Power Beam. I mean, come on, make it my natural energies or something. Well, you know what? We're at the end, so let's just drain him like this. I don't see why not, because now all of his health is down. And... is he dead? Or is there a second phase? Maybe there's a second phase. Maybe I'm getting my hopes up a little bit too much, but I don't know. All I can say is... let's just venture down and see what's going on. This is going not bad. I like this a lot. Oh my god. This must be the true one, right? Oh my god. What in the hell is this thing? Now, can I scan you? I want to scan you before doing anything. Alright, cool, yes, add to my logbook. Brilliant. Wait, oh my god, I actually accidentally did all of that. Hold on, wait, I want to read it again. Okay, Metroid Prime, the core essence of Metroid Prime. Oh, this is the core essence, huh? Scan indicates that the Phazon energy form of Metroid Prime is invulnerable to all conventional weapons. Only attacks from a Phazon-fused arm cannon will damage it, okay. Right, okay, I need to keep note of that, let me have a think. It generates pools of Phazon when it attacks. Use these to fuel your suit's Phazon weapon system. Right. The entity can also spawn Metroids to assist it in battle, rendering itself invisible when it does so. Alright, cool. So I need to collect some stuff then in order to do stuff, right? Because nothing damages this thing. Nothing at all. I gotta keep note of that. So then I need to collect these, I think, in order to maybe kill it. At least that's my theory, anyway. Because if I try shooting it like this, nothing happens. And it told me that when it goes invisible, there's like Metroids that appear, right? However, I have a whole bunch of power bombs, right? So now if I go to this, yeah, I can see them like this, right? And I can't shoot it, so I can't really do much while it's doing it, right? Unless maybe what I need to do is go to this thing? Is that right? Hyper mode? Oh my god, no way, really? Holy crap, this is so cool, but I need to put on my invisibility suit. Because then I can actually get him done like this, right? Where's it gone now? It's gone about here. Here it is. Okay, right. I wanna have a look around. Where is it? Where's it gone? It's right about... Hold on. Is it above me? I really can't tell where the hell it is. I know it's somewhere. Hold the phone. Anywhere around? Hello? Hang on. So it's invisible. It's around here somewhere. Alright, now it's gone this time. It's probably moved over, isn't it? This, I don't know, but still, at least I know for sure, though, that that hyper thing actually damages it in the first place, doesn't it? Is that one right there? Yeah, it is. Okay, right, so I've got to switch to this. And take it down, maybe? Oh, hang on, there it is. Right, let's just drain it all down like this, then, shall we, huh? How long can I do this for? Quite a while. That's pretty cool, man. So then, the main tactic is dodge. Just continuously dodge it and stuff, and then wait for the things to arrive, and then I can melt it. It's a really cool, man. That's what I've been saying, but honestly, it's a really cool way to put the ends to a boss and stuff. Ah, boy. And I'm honestly surprised about my level of, like, energy tanks and things. So, let's see now. Let's just try and avoid all of this, and I get the feeling he's gonna summon Metroids at some point as well, isn't he? Yep, because now he's gonna go invisible, isn't he? Yep, there he goes. He's going invisible now, and now I can find where he is around. There he is. Right, yeah, I knew he was somewhere. Oh my god, wow. Oh, freaking hell, these blimmin' things. Well, you can just die. Thank you. Right. Okay, let's have a look around again, just to be sure. You are somewhere. Activate the thing. Hold on, there you are. Let's just melt you down like this then, shall we? Okay, right, wow, so this probably takes like probably about 5 hits, is my estimation in that, in order to get him down. Where are you this time? How is he gone? He's around somewhere, right. Yeah, so need to keep this on, right, in order to find him? There's another bit over there though, and oh my god, you again, huh? Can I just get you down nice and easily? You know what, just one power bomb might actually do, just to destroy all of you, right? Except for that thing over there. That thing's really annoying. Can I just get you down? Like, with one thing, maybe? At all? Hello? You gonna blow up? Yeah, you are. Alright, cool. So now let's just go onto this and melt him! Maybe? Yeah, there we go. I was gonna say, I thought I didn't, like, lock him into the thing. Well, that is a shame. And oh my god, I'm missing, like, 2 energy tanks so far. Well, god damn it, this is so intense. And I... Oh, it's so good. Again, though, with my commentary and stuff, I'm so focused trying to kill this thing that I don't really have a lot to say. Like, what the hell do I even do on a thing like this? Oh my god. Okay, right, I need a phazon. Any phazons at all? Yeah, there's one over there. Right. Okay, now, again, as per usual, power bomb. Ready? Power bomb to get rid of everything. Because that makes things a hell of a lot more easier for me, man. Alright, go to this. Go to it. Do it. Okay, right. And now, melt him, right? I think, anyway. Yeah, there we go. I locked him. Keep on doing it! How much times can I actually hit him and stuff? Because he's like halfway down now. And my health? I've got plenty. I've got plenty of health and that helped me out, haven't I? Except, does he actually stay invisible? He does, okay. So I need to keep note of that. And now he's doing that thing again. So it's every time he makes the noise, isn't it? Because if I keep locked onto him, it'll make it a little bit easier. So then I'm not going to take a hit every goddamn time, you know? How many times is he going to do that, though? He does that for a while, and then Phazon appears around here. Here it is. And I have, like, all these, so, you know what? Power bombs are my key in order to make things a lot easier for me for a place like this, you know? Okay, right, so now, you can just die, if you could kindly, with my power bomb. Can you get into the radiation, please? Thank you. Okay, now I want to switch to... God damn it, switch to this. And then have a look around, trying to identify where the hell he is. So he's right about... Where is he? I can't find him. Hold on, wait. Where is he? Oh my god, wait, I think I saw him. He's right... Wait, where's the prime thing? The prime thing's gone. Oh wow, it's over here this time. Oh my god, ah! Okay, right, ready? Another power bomb, go for it. Turn around. And then try to shoot the prime. There we go, right. That's a lot better. Keep doing it! And now his health is virtually all done. Bloody hell, man, this is so goddamn cool. Okay. He's gonna go back to his normal phase, right? Yep, back to this explosion. Honestly, for the last boss in that, he doesn't really have that much combinations that you have to try to avoid. The only annoying ones, really, are just trying to take out those Metroids that he tries to summon. But again, surely the phase on thing can destroy them anyway. Why am I not doing that? Because if they're immune to that, then surely they are the final boss. If the final boss in that is immune to it, but these things aren't, then that's the most strangest thing of all time. Alright, cool, so let's just turn around. Trying to melt. Yeah, I knew it! Okay, cool. I should be doing this more then. Right, so where is he? He's around here somewhere. I need to animate my... There you are, right. Yeah, let's just get you down. God damn you. Really? You've already gone back to your normal phase, huh? Alright, keep on the locked on thing. With like the x-ray and stuff just to make this a bit easier. Alright. What are you doing now? Whoa, 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 what? Alright, I thought he was doing like a different move or so then. Never mind. Okay. Metro Prime. Alright, he's doing that again. I swear he's taking longer to do it this time as well. Alright, now, the phase on thing is over there. I feel really stupid though for not doing this like in the first place. Why did I not think to get rid of them like that? It's making it a little bit easier, doesn't it? Alright, cool, so you are... Well, goddammit, it's gone away again, hasn't it? So I gotta be quick with it in order to take him out in the last phase, right? Yeah. So let's just activate my x-ray and then just try to find out where the hell he is. Any phase on? Any, like, any of this blimmin' hyper mode stuff that I can use in order to kick this guy's butt? Let's have a look around. Anything? Anything at all? It doesn't look like it. He's just carrying on doing his normal thing, right? Okay, is he doing it again? No, there's one over there, actually. I want to quickly go over to that, turn around, and then kill everything with this. Right, okay. Oh my god, wait. Hold on, where is he? He's right over here! Can I get him done? Is he done yet? Oh my god! Yes! He is! For a second there, I was going to say no, he isn't, because I thought he had one little bit of health, but whatever. Metroid Prime is defeated! I think that's the final boss actually done, isn't it? Second phase is pretty easy to follow, man. Awesome. But now what? Is it gonna self-destruct, so I'm gonna have to return to my ship, right? Is that the answer? Oh my god, what? What? What is even... It just ripped my phase-on suit. Oh my god, man! This is so intense! Like, Jesus! Okay, I need to get the hell out of here, right? Crater collapse imminent. Evacuating me. Yep, I knew it! I called it! So I need to try and get out of here before the place actually blows up entirety, right? I need to return to my ship. Or is it done it for me? Has it done it for me? Oh, hang on. No, wait. What is going on? Oh, well, no, I actually call my ship. Oh, so I don't have to run back to it. You always have to do that in the other Metroid games.
Chozo's faith and service has been well rewarded. And now, a new star shines in the universe. The Bounty Hunter, Samus Aran. What future and fate await her?
Oh wow, we actually get to see her face as well, do we? Probably because I collect 100% items? I don't know, but I approve. Anyway. That's good detail for the GameCube! My god. Impressive stuff, man. And that's the end of the game. Oh my god, wow. I've actually finished this LP. Holy crap. All I can say is, what a game. Oh my god, wow. I have really goddamn enjoyed doing this LP. At first, like, I thought I was against trying to do Metroid Prime because I thought I would struggle. But honestly, I haven't died once, like, playing through the whole thing and that. And that makes me happy alone, but this... This is a really good GameCube game. I don't know how I played this, you know, like, back then. Didn't really get that far in it at all, and then just came away from it. Why did I come away from this game? This game is great. The whole design and everything is just... Wow, I can see, you know, why people consider this, like, some of the... If not the best, like, entry in the Metroid series and stuff. Although, personally, in my opinion, my heart belongs more to Super Metroid for the Super Nintendo and stuff. Personally. That's not to say that this game sucked, though. This game definitely does not suck. It's so good. I am so glad I chose to, like, do a blind LP of this game and stuff. And thanks to, you know, people like Hyper Shadow and Dylan Singewald and the number one guy and stuff for telling me, like, all the tips and stuff. And just for all of you guys viewing who have enjoyed, like, this whole LP or just blind LP of Metroid Prime Blind and stuff. It's really weird to be recording this now, like, seeing the credits and stuff, you know, with, like, 100% items and stuff like that, but still, oh my god, wow. I just love it and things. But honestly, I don't think it ends here either, because, I'm pretty sure I told one of the people that was viewing this that I said I would show off, you know, like, there's certain things that you get which you can buy with, the points now on, like, you know, Metroid Prime Trilogy as, like, a shop where you can buy, like, apparently the Metroid Fusion suit, so I might be showing my reactions to those, but I'm not sure. It's kind of the same thing, you know, of what happened with Sonic Heroes and doing, like, the whole two-player side of things. I mean, I said I'd do that, but in the end it sort of happened, but it didn't. So it might be the same thing, but I don't know, really. Yeah, other than that, that's pretty much all I'm going to do for Metroid Prime stuff, really. I'm going to be showing off just bonus content if I feel like it. You know, it just depends. But all I can say is the main LP is actually done. I'm really happy about it, and this was a bloody spectacular game to play. Oh my god, I would recommend you to play this. Like, if you have a Nintendo GameCube, buy it. If you have a Nintendo Wii, buy it on there. If you even have a Wii U and, you know, you want to get the game on, like, the Wii U eShop, buy it. Just buy it, okay? It's really good. And all I can say is, you know, if, like, this series of Metroid Prime Blind and that takes off really well, I may do Metroid Prime 2 Echoes Blind. We will see, okay? If it doesn't, then I'll just probably play it in my spare time, pretty much like how I beat, you know, did Donkey Kong Country Blind, and that was fun, and then I just played number 2 in my spare time and stuff. But we'll just play it by ear, and we'll see how this series actually takes off in, like, around, I don't know, like, a couple of months down the line and stuff, but still, because this has been, like, a project or so, which has gone on for, like, 2 months. Nice. Oh, hang on, wait. Mission final. Percentage complete, 100%, total time 19, hyper mode difficulty unlocked. Oh my god, wow. Also, it doesn't actually tell you about the scanning, I don't think, at the end? Because it told me the percentage complete is 100%. Yeah, so I literally have beat this game to 100%! Oh my god, that's really cool, man. What? I mean, I know it said it in my save file and stuff, but I thought that was literally only just for the items and stuff. So what is the scanning actually for? What does it do? Like, does it unlock something completely extra? I don't know and stuff, but still. I'm just gonna click A to continue then, and see what happens. So I'm unlocked hyper mode. That's cool. Oh, hang on, there's a cutscene. Oh my god. It has a cliffhanger. Choosing to save now will finish this game of Metroid Prime. When you select your save slot again, you will start a new game. Great, I'm on, like, this type of thing, am I? Let me have a think for a second. I'm gonna go with no. Just so then I can easily just look around the world anytime and then just play the final boss again. And then just learn things a bit better. Because if I want to start a new game, I'm probably gonna start another save slot. You know, in the one next to it or so, anyway. Because my other one, which I played for, like, probably just past the first level, and that probably needs to be deleted now, because that's completely obsolete. That says, like, what, 2%? Next to a file now that says 100%, so that's completely different, isn't it? So I'm gonna go, no. Because, I mean, I can always decide on it later, and the stuff, you know, I can just beat the boss again and be like, yeah, I'll do it this time. I just do it, like, in my spare time for whatever's going on, you know? So, what's gonna happen now? Oh, it's gonna kick me back to the Metroid Prime Trilogy screen, right? Cool. Well, then, I guess this is the end of Metroid Prime Blind for the Wii. It's been a really, really fun ride from beginning to end and stuff, albeit a very long series. I didn't really plan for it to be this long, to be honest. It was around the same sort of length when I did, you know, a blind LP of Spyro free Year of the Dragon for the PS1, which is back in 2015. That was like a 3-month project, but this has been a 2-month project and stuff, and it's been incredibly fun. I'm so glad that you guys have enjoyed watching it and stuff, and I guess I might as well announce a couple of things that I'm going to be doing, like for this channel and stuff, now that Metro Prime's all out of the way. So, while I have been doing Metro Prime and stuff, I've had actually a lot of plans as to what I'm going to show after this series has ended. My next LP after this, I'm going to get to that straight away, just so you guys are aware, is a game that I've wanted to tackle for a while, and no, it's not going to be a blind LP, it's just going to be a regular LP of a game which is actually my favorite game of all time. I've wanted to do this game for ages, like even before I've started, you know, my YouTube channel, which was back in August 5th of 2012, which is goddamn long ago, oh my god. I'm going to be doing that game next, and what is that game, you might ask? It's The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. That's going to be for the N64 and stuff. I'm going to be collecting all the masks, and it's going to be beat to 100%. So it's going to be even more of a bigger project, you know, of Metroid Prime. I mean, I thought this was big enough, but no, Metroid Mask, yeah. No, Majora's Mask in that is going to be even bigger, because, you know, it's just going to have all the masks collected, all the heart containers, just everything. The whole world is going to be dissected, and I'm going to do my absolute best to show off why I find it my favorite game of all time and stuff. It's going to be a long ride, but I don't care. It's my favorite game of all time. Man, as long as I'm playing it, I don't give a damn, but still. And as well as that, I can't really jump onto Majora's Mask, like, immediately. I mean, like, straight away after Prime, because, I mean, I've got to make all the graphics and the aesthetics, you know? I need to make, like, the banners, I need to make an intro for it, I need to make an end slate or an outro for it, you know, much like I did with Metroid Prime at the end of every episode, where that was, like, in the form of Samus's visor of scanning. It will probably be something different with Majora's Mask. So it may take a while to make and stuff, but I have also been planning to do a couple of things as well. So, I have this series known as One-Off Let's Plays and One-Off Let's Plays Bond Edition, but I think I'm starting to change a couple of things, actually, where I'm starting to change the actual titles now, where the One-Off Let's Plays Blind Editions, well, then we just changed the titles of Trying Out. In this case, you saw this if you saw my video, which was, Trying Out The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. You know, it was me just playing Breath of the Wild for the Wii U for a couple of minutes, and just seeing what it was like and stuff, because I don't know, just doing One-Off Let's Plays Blind Edition of random PS2 games and stuff, I don't know, it doesn't really seem professional anymore to me and stuff, and I'm trying to get bored of it, because you don't want to do the same thing all the time. I mean, I've been doing that for like nearly 2 years now, and I'm kind of like, I want to move on and do a couple of things different. And the Metroid stuff hasn't actually ended, because I too have actually more Metroid stuff planned going on, where now, since Metroid Prime is done, I might as well do this little sort of mini-series. It's probably not going to be the whole game beaten, but I'm going to be calling it Let's Break Super Metroid. And what that's basically going to be is me playing through Super Metroid for the Super Nintendo, but showing off sequence-breaking tactics you can do. In other words, with bomb jumping, the mock ball, as well as shine-sparking tactics, you know, in order to get items really early in the game, and just show you, you know, what is possible for Super Metroid and why I love it. And plus, I'm breaking the game, hence that's why it's called Let's Break Super Metroid and stuff, you know? As well as that, though, I also plan to do a Trying Out. I was going to say One-Off Let's Plays Blind Edition then, but I might as well just call Trying Out of a ROM that I've never tried before, and it piqued my interest. Super Metroid is one of my favorite games of all time, and there's a ROM that's actually for the Super Nintendo, which I wasn't aware about to this day, even though it's been around forever, known as Super Metroid Impossible, which is basically, you know, Super Metroid, but with more added spikes, and the difficulty is spiked up, hence that's why it's called Super Metroid Impossible, meaning the game is brutally difficult, allowing you to use, you know, all your sequence-breaking tactics to your best advantage, and I don't know, I think it'll be a fun time doing, like, a little Trying Out or a one-off on that, if you will, so I'll be doing that as well. And that's it for the Metroid stuff as well. I also have plans to do another Let's Break, where I'm going to be showing off Spyro 2 Gateway to Glimmer for the PS1. Yeah, that's going to be different, that one, really, because there's actually a certain thing you can do in the game, which kind of breaks every level in the game. At least when you get the hang of, like, the timing and all that. So I'm going to be showing off, you know, how you can break Spyro 2 through, like, doing a certain combination of buttons, as well as a little bit of glitching, but not too much, because I'm not the best when it comes to glitches. So, you know, basically Super Metroid and Spyro 2 are going to be a Let's Break series. I don't know if I have plans to do any other games, we'll see in the future and stuff, but still. And on top of that, it's like I'm reading out a list or something. I've also been doing like a side project with a fellow of mine known as HarryTM12, where we came up with this series or so, where we explained about, you know, one of us is going to play through a game that we've never played before, and the other one has, and they're going to guide us through it. And we chose two games to do it with. I was chosen, or at least we both chose, to do Shelter, this PC game that was released in 2013 and that, which is like not that long at all, so it's more of like a mini-series going on, where Harry has played through it before, and you know, I played through my first time on the PC and stuff, and just see how it goes, as well as he guides me and helps me out. It's a fun little series, so that'll be coming soon. And I'm also going to be joining on his channel as well, so if you hop on over to HarryTM12's channel, at some point in time, I don't know when, but I'll let you guys know at some point, whenever it's out, he's going to be playing through Banjo-Kazooie for his first time. Banjo-Kazooie is actually one of my favourite games of all time. In fact, it's my second favourite game of all time next to Majora's Mask. He's never played it through it before and stuff, so he's going to be playing through that, and I'm going to be there guiding him and stuff, you know, helping him out. And it's going to be like a series you can watch if you please for something that I star on like another channel and stuff, but still. And after that, I guess I'm just going to be doing, like, showing off games in my collection that I want to show off and things, depending on what I feel like. Because I might show off, like, Sonic Riders for the PS2, because that's a really underappreciated game. I like it a lot. A lot of people hate it, and I don't know why. And I'm going to do my best, you know, to show why I don't think it's that bad. Like how I did with Sonic Heroes and stuff, but it'll be, like, just a one-off, but still. But yeah, let's just say after Prime and that, I've had a lot of plans to what to show afterwards and that. And during all that, at some point in time, the LP of The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask will begin. So I hope you guys look forward to that. And, as usual, take care. I am Calham64, and this has been Metroid Prime Blind on the Wii. Even though it's for the GameCube, but still. So take care, and see you then.